Hello, my name is Nitin. The 5G network footprint is steadily increasing. Any device offering 5G New Radio FR2, which transmits at frequencies above 6 GHz, needs to be tested for power density compliance to obtain regulatory device approval. The new devices will have multiple input, multiple output or MIMO antennas offering multiple beam configurations that pose new challenges for design and certifications. Again, Spear is one step ahead in providing simulation platforms for design and measurement systems for certifications that are based on the same code. I think if they manage that, both the simulation platform and measurement system smoothly play together, this would simplify the whole R&D phase from prototyping to certification of the final device. Let's test this. This is a proposed 27 GHz validation device with 64 radiating elements divided into 16 independent subarrays that can be individually controlled to form different beams. In the first step, we have evaluated the device with the SemCAD-X version 19, that is part of the Sim4Life version 6.0. The CAD file of the device provided by the manufacturer is imported, and I can easily configure the multiport finite difference time domain or FDTD simulation by using drag and drop. I set broadband excitation centered at 27 GHz. I had to enter some of the dielectric properties manually, but the grid was generated automatically with around 90 million grid cells. Nevertheless, it is wise to check the voxels, for example, to make sure that all 64 radiating patches are correctly connected to the ground plate by the excitation sources or microstrip lines. I already started the simulations yesterday, and all results for the 16-port simulation are available now for performing the post-processing. It took less than 12 hours on a workstation with 8 Titan 10 graphics cards, thanks to parallelization and to the massive speed-up offered by the GPU-accelerated solvers. I will now demonstrate how to explore different configurations at post-processing stage. I can form beams corresponding to any codebook configuration and visualize the electric near field at the same time. The new power density evaluator is compliant with the very latest draft of the IEC IEEE standard and is very easy to use. I can define evaluation surfaces using an interactive tool, which is convenient for planar surfaces or from CAD objects like the SAM head here. The fields are first interpolated onto the discretized evaluation surface and then an averaging algorithm is applied. The evaluator lets me choose the refinement precision of the surface mesh. The standard requires a discretization of 1 mm or less, but I can use larger values for ultra fast first approximations. I can choose the shape of the averaging area, here a square or a circle, as well as the surface area itself, like 1 or 4 cm squared. This evaluator is super fast, so I can apply it in near real time for all beam configurations. The evaluator can also be used on curved surfaces like on the SAM head here. It is also fast enough to use on large surfaces, for example, the skin of an anatomical human model. We can clearly see where the beam is impinging the body here. To be compliant with the standard, we also need to find largest power density value that can be achieved across all configurations. Since there are only 55 of them, we can easily try them all and identify the worst case, which is around 20 watt per square meter on the SAM head in the touch position. Now, we evaluate the same device with DAISY 6 module millimeter wave shown here without knowing the simulation results near the structure. The only thing we need to know is the input vectors of 17 different configurations from the codebook. First, I set up the measurements using the advanced alpha release of DAISY 6 module millimeter wave 2.2 that I have received from Shpyag for testing. For this assessment, I choose to measure each one of the 16 array elements individually, followed by a combination which steers the beam to plus 60 degree in azimuth and plus 10 degree in elevation. The GUI switches the antenna beams one by one, creates a corresponding FT scan in the project file and proceeds to measure it. I accelerate the video. The validation device is controlled via this graphical user interface, which also controls the DAISY 6 module via the advanced application programming interface, in short, the API. The new API feature of DAISY 6 millimeter wave module 2.2 allows remote control of the system via HTTP commands. To set up the measurement, I select all the antenna element measurements and start a forward transform or FT scan with appropriate dimensions to completely cover the radiating part of the device. Now, all cases have been measured. To evaluate the worst case, I start the maximum exposure optimizer or MEO option and add the 17 measurements to the MEO window and define the phase and amplitude values for each of the measurements. Next, I select the SAM right head and flat phantoms to evaluate the worst case power density and start the optimizer. The optimizer evaluates the measured data and finds the phase or amplitude combination giving the worst case power density on the SAM right head and flat phantoms. Indeed, simulation and measurement results in the same worst case configuration with a deviation of only 1 dB. This is very good considering that the validation device has not been fully calibrated yet. The validation device seems suitable as a validation device for the MIMO implementation, but will need extensive calibration by Shpyag of the radiated power and phase of each element until it can be employed as a standardized validation device. The biggest advantage of these tools is that they are based on the same code and that files can be exchanged. Furthermore, in the next version, it will be possible to directly load the measurement files into the simulation platforms Sim4Life version 6.2 and SimCADX version 19.2 for further advanced evaluations. The direct and smooth inter-exchangeable use of the experimental and simulation tools is a dream for engineers like me. For more information about the latest DAISY 8 module millimeter wave is available at www.speag.swiss, and more information about the just released Sim4Life version 6.0 can be found at www.zmt.swiss. Thanks for watching this video.